So what am I going to do with you? You have to help me out. Sati is really of, I mean, of the utmost importance. Sati is our eyes, you know. If you constantly close our eyes, I mean, how can we see? And I don't know how, I mean, why is it not possible for you, you know, to develop this kind of sati, you know, that helps you on makkhapala? I mean, just these simple tasks, you know, taking care of my kuti, you know. I mean, it's 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Can you have sati just within these 10 minutes or 15 minutes? Is it possible that you know what you're doing? Folding the ropes, huh? I mean, when I became a bhikkhu, I folded the ropes twice or three times, oh, with the help of another bhikkhu. And then I always folded it in the same way. So when I take it, you know, when I take it in the morning for pindapat, put it on, you know, it opens up always in the same way. I mean, you don't have to think, you just open it up, you know, and you put it together and then you put it around, you know, and it's never wrong. Now each time, you know, I have to figure out, you know, where's the start and where's the end, because you always fold it differently each time. I mean, folding the ropes, I mean, what does it take? 2 minutes? Sati for 2 minutes, is it possible? I mean, just know, I don't know, just know what you're doing. Just be aware. What is so difficult? Let me know, what is so difficult? Just doing one thing at a time. I mean, we train that with our samadhi, we train to be always on the object, be it the Buddha or be it the breath. So why is it so difficult, you know, to be, you know, when you're sweeping, be while you're sweeping, you know, be it on the broom or you're on your body. Huh? Don't think. I really don't know. I mean, I really don't know how to help you anymore. I don't see, you know, I mean, I don't see that it is improving. I mean, so there's something wrong. I mean, a person who is sati, I mean, you instantly notice it. I mean, he's present. I mean, that's the same of awareness. I mean, he's present. He's not lost in his thoughts. He's present, completely present. Knows exactly, you know, I mean, he reacts to any kind of situation in a very normal way. He's not preoccupied with this thought, what should I do, you know, how should I do it, and things like that. I mean, learn it with sati once, you know, how to do things, you know, and then you never need to remember. This presence, I mean, that is what is lacking, you know. I mean, I want to see that within you. Mm? I really want to see it. Mm? I mean, this, it's amazing. Mm? It's amazing state of mind, this presence of mind. Mm? Just present. Mm? Being in the present moment without any thoughts lingering around. Mm? Can you do that? I mean, it's all, you know, all what I try to teach you. It's not, you know, not to make you disheartened, you know, but, you know, to encourage you to practice for your own sake. You don't practice for anybody else, but for your own sake. It's you, you are full of dukkha. Your heart is full of dukkha. Your heart is oppressed by the kilesas. I mean, tell yourself, give me a break, you know, and enter samadhi. I really want, you know, to see, you know, you're entering apana samadhi, the state, you know, of this pure presence of mind. At least then you have a basis from where you can go. Or, you know, if it's not apana samadhi, then at least the deeper state of upachara samadhi, the excess samadhi. I mean, where your thoughts, you know, disappear, you know, for hours. Huh? And then when you come out, you know, I mean, you see how disturbing these thoughts are. What a kind of nuisance. Oh, I mean, why do you still, you know, I mean, you chew on them, you know, I mean, you chew on them, you know, for 100 times on the same thought. The same thought chain. I mean, take a chewing gum, you know, I put it in your mouth after 2 or 3 minutes, it's getting boring because there's no taste in it anymore. So why do you chew on the same thoughts, you know, for hours, for days, for weeks? Huh? It's always the same thought. Huh? I mean, it's not boring, huh? Can't you see it? Can you try at least? Huh? I mean, this is my joy when I see, you know, that your practice is, you know, going forward. Huh? When I see that you stagnate, you know, I lose my interest as well. Huh? I lose my interest in teaching you. I mean, if you stagnate, you know, I mean, why should I bother? Why should I say anything? I mean, I just let you live your life, you know, just like you did it before. Yeah? I mean, before you weren't monks, you know. Now you find it comfortable, you know, to be monks. So, I mean, just go ahead, you know, roll along with the kilesas in command. I mean, they tell you what to do, you know, and you say, yes, my lord, you know, okay, it's fine, you know. Because if I go against you, I mean, you will put a lot of pressure, you know, and you create so much dukkha, I mean, I can't stand it. Huh? So if you stagnate in this way, you know, what shall I do, you know, tell me. Huh? Shall I always, you know, be with the hammer around, you know, and give you a good beat? No. I mean, it's not a pleasure, you know, to constantly admonish you. I mean, I really, you know, I mean, it is a pleasure for me if I really hear nice stories of your practice, you know, how you succeed, even if it's just a fight, you know, between the kilesas, but you manage to be successful, you know? You manage victory. Or you just, you know, you just enter that presence of moment, you know, just for a few seconds. Huh? I mean, that is, you know, that is really enjoyable for me to hear. But, you know, this just dragging along, dragging along, dragging along. But really, you know, I mean, then everything else, you know, if you don't have sati, if you can't see, you know, I mean, then what's the use, you know, of telling you all, you know, how to go the way of wisdom, you know, how to defeat the kilesas? If you can't even see the kilesas, if you don't have this presence of mind, how can you see the kilesas? Huh? How can you see them at work, you know? I mean, you're constantly deceived by them, you're constantly fooled by them, they're constantly, you know, I mean, dancing on your head, you know, or dancing on your nose, or whatever you like. And they have a good laugh. Huh? Huh. And it's so easy to keep you under control. Huh? It's so easy, you know, to keep you in the realms of birth and death. Huh? I mean, is that really what you want, you know, to die and be born again and die and be born again, you know, uncountable times? Is that really what you wish for? Is that what you want, you know? If you don't put up a fight, you know, I mean, you will be in the chain of birth and death. If you don't put up the fight, you know, I mean, as long as the oppressor is so strong, I mean, and when you read the talks of Lung Dhamma Hapo, I mean, there's no stronger kilesa than the karma kilesa, the kilesa of sensual and sexual lust. I mean, and it oppresses the hearts of people, I mean, for ages, for eons over eons. So, I mean, do you think, you know, you can persuade this kilesa to go away? Yeah, I mean, I'm sick of all these sexual and sensual desires, you know, so please go away. You think you can do that? It will go? You have to cut it out, you have to tear it out. That's the only way how you get rid of it. But if you can't see, you know, I mean, what can you do? I mean, it's just like blind people stumbling along the way, you know, I mean thinking that the tree, you know, is a person, you know, or thinking that the person is a tree. You don't know anything. You don't see anything because, I mean, your presence of mind is not there, your sati is not there. And so how can you walk along the path? How can you go on? If you don't know what is what? I mean, only when we open our eyes we see what is what. But if you don't open the eyes, because, I mean, it's so difficult, you know, I mean, it's just like, you know, we wake up from a sleep, you know, a sweet dream, and we just don't want to open our eyes. No? We just want to live in this dream, you know, in this imagination of ours. No? What is nothing else than samut, you know, I mean, the conventional reality, I mean, the illusion. No? It's so nice, I mean, we open our physical eyes and we see the trees, we hear the birds, you know, we see the birds, you know, we see the food, you know, it's all nice. So, I mean, what's the problem? I don't mean this physical eyes to open it. I mean to open the inner eyes to sati. No? Without sati, I mean, there's just no going forward. No? It's just running around in circles. This sati, this presence of mind, just, you know, just experience it for one moment, you know, and then you know what I'm talking about. And this presence of mind, you know, Lung Dhamma Hapo says there are no kilesas. Of course there are no kilesas, because you're present. Huh? You're completely there. You're completely, fully aware. And there are, in that moment, there are no kilesas. No? Get it. Yeah? I mean, I don't know. Yeah? Tell me, you know, what to do. Huh? I mean, if you don't want me, you know, to go into silence, you know, for the next 3 months now, because the rains retreat start, huh? Do something. Show me something. Yeah? Show me that you're really interested in fighting the kilesa. Show me that you're really on. Show me that you're really trying. At least I want to see that you're really trying. Not just, you know, I mean, proceeding from day to day, you know, hanging on, tracking yourself from day to day. I mean, it's a waste of time and it's a waste of energy. Don't get fooled by the kilesas to fight them in the wrong way. Get your presence of mind and then you see, you know, how to fight them. You see where they are, you know, and then you can slash out at them. But if not, no? If you grope in the dark, I mean, you know, I mean, all what you see are shadows, huh? And you don't even know if the shadow is a tree or if it's a person. Hmm? Getting angry at a person that is actually a tree, you know, and and thinking that the tree is a person. That's not going to work. So give me some encouragement, you know, why I should, you know, go on. And then I don't, you know, I feel less and less inclined. Post me some problems, you know, in your practice, you know, I mean, that are really interesting, that shows that you're, I mean, that you're doing. You know? I mean, as I said, you know, I want, you know, at least I want to see that you're trying. And so, is it so difficult, you know, just for 10 minutes, I mean, taking care of my kuti, you know, or folding the ropes, you know, just the bowl, you know, I mean, sometimes, you know, my bowl is not, I mean, the the strap is too long, or the strap is too short, you know, sometimes there's still water in the bowl, I mean, don't you see it? What do you think when you're doing these things? And now stop thinking while you're doing these things and just be present. Just have mindfulness. Just, you know, just be aware of what is going on. So that's all what I want to say. I mean, really. I mean, you really have to help me. Okay, go on with your night.